Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and all brave souls. Welcome to Terrifying Tales, your home for all things eerie. And welcome to True Pizza Delivery Nightmares. Are you ready for a slice of terror? Our host's voice echoes through the screen, the tone eerie and chilling, setting the mood for the stories to follow. The screen fades to black for a moment, before opening to an animated scene of a stormy night, lightning illuminating the silhouette of a pizza joint. Inside, we see a lone figure, a pizza delivery guy, preparing to close shop for the night. The rain splatters against the windows, the wind howling outside, the atmosphere heavy with a sense of foreboding. A phone rings, the sound echoing in the nearly empty pizzeria, jarring the silence. The delivery guy, let's call him John, picks up the phone, the voice on the other end sending a chill down his spine. But John is not one to back down. He takes the order, unknowingly setting into motion a series of events that will lead to an unforgettable night of terror. Are you ready to delve into the unknown, to uncover the eerie tales of late-night pizza deliveries? Brace yourself, for what lies ahead is not for the faint-hearted. Welcome to our spine-chilling saga, The Late Night Call. Ever heard a pizza order that chills you to the bone? Our tale begins on a stormy night, the darkness of the hour only deepened by the heavy rain pouring down. A pizza delivery guy, let's call him John, was about to call it a day when the phone rang, echoing eerily in the nearly empty pizza joint. The voice on the other end was unsettling, a whispery tone that seemed to echo around the room. It was a request for a late-night delivery. The address given was one unfamiliar to John, located on the outskirts of town, a place where the city lights barely reached. But John, having a heart as big as his bravery, decided to fulfill this unusual request. Now, this wasn't just an ordinary pizza order. The voice, with its strange, chilling timbre, specifically mentioned the delivery was to be made to the basement. Yes, you heard right, the basement. An unusual request for any pizza delivery, wouldn't you agree? But John shrugged it off, thinking it was probably some kind of prank. He prepared the order, a large pepperoni with extra cheese, and set off into the night, the rain pelting down on his windshield. The journey was long and lonely, the road stretching out into the darkness, a ribbon of black asphalt, the only company his wipers rhythmically pushing away the relentless rain. As he drove, the city lights faded behind him, replaced by the dark silhouettes of trees and the occasional flicker of lightning illuminating the desolate landscape. His GPS guided him through the winding roads, leading him further into the remote location. The atmosphere was heavy, the eerie voice from the call still echoing in his mind, the request for the basement delivery haunting his thoughts. But John was not one to back down. He was determined to complete the delivery, no matter how strange or unsettling the circumstances. After all, it was just a pizza delivery, right? Little did he know this wasn't an ordinary pizza delivery. Imagine delivering pizza to a house that shouldn't exist. In the heart of a forgotten neighborhood, our pizza delivery guy finds himself before a desolate house, the supposed destination of a steaming hot pizza. The house, shrouded in the cloak of darkness, looms ominously before him. Its once vibrant paint now peels off in sorrow, the windows blank and vacant, its garden overgrown with the neglect of time. A chilling wind whistles through the skeletal trees, whispering eerie tales of a time long past. With a gulp, he steps onto the cracked path leading to the house. The crunch of gravel beneath his feet echoes in the still night, the only other sound being the distant hoot of an owl, a lone sentinel in this forsaken place. The house, as if possessing a life of its own, seems to watch his every move. In the eerie silence, a faint noise filters through the night air. It's coming from the basement, a strange, inhuman sound that sends shivers down his spine. He stands frozen, his heart hammering against his ribs. Every instinct screams at him to turn back, to flee from the place that shouldn't exist. But he's here to do a job, and he's never left a delivery incomplete. With a deep breath, he steels himself and moves towards the source of the sound. The rusted basement door creaks open under his touch, revealing a pitch-black void. The noises grow louder, more frantic. He's on the precipice of an abyss, teetering between the known and the unknown. The pizza box grows heavy in his hands, a physical reminder of his duty. His mind races, a whirlwind of fear and determination. He is but a humble pizza guy, yet he finds himself in a situation straight out of a horror movie. But he's made his decision. He's chosen to walk into the darkness, into the heart of the desolate house. He was about to encounter the unimaginable. What terror lurks in the shadows of an abandoned basement? Picture this. A pizza delivery guy, just a regular fellow like you or me, steps over the threshold into a basement. The air is stale, filled with the scent of dampness and decay, the remnants of a life that once was. His only companion is the pitch-black darkness that engulfs everything, turning the mundane into the menacing. His heart pounds in his chest as he reaches into the abyss, fingers desperately seeking the comfort of a light switch. But the only response is the cold touch of moistened walls and an icy chill that snakes its way up his spine. It's as though the very air is alive, whispering secrets of the past into his ear, secrets that fill him with a dread he can't quite comprehend. The whispers grow louder, morphing into a cacophony of voices that seem to be coming from everywhere and nowhere all at once. They seem to be saying something, a message perhaps, but it's lost in the chaos, lost in the fear that's now coursing through his veins. And then, out of the corner of his eye, he sees it. A ghastly figure, ethereal and vague, but undeniably there. It's as though the shadows themselves have taken form, a terrifying embodiment of the unseen terror that's been haunting his every step. His breath catches in his throat as he stares, transfixed by the horrifying spectacle before him. But then the spell is broken. The figure lunges towards him and he's running, running as fast as his legs can carry him. He doesn't dare look back for he knows what he'll see. The terror, the unseen terror, is right behind him. He bursts out of the house, gasping for breath, heart pounding like a drum. He's safe for now, but the terror, the unseen terror, it's still there, lurking in the shadows of that abandoned basement, waiting. That night he delivered more than just a pizza. He delivered a horrifying experience that would haunt him forever. What happens when a pizza delivery turns into a ghostly encounter? Let us introduce you to Sarah, a vivacious young woman making her living by delivering pizzas around town. On one fateful night, she receives a call from an old apartment building nestled in a forgotten corner of the town. This isn't just any apartment building, however. It's one that has an unsavory reputation, covered in a cloak of whispered tales of eerie apparitions and haunted happenings. The building, with its crumbling bricks and peeling paint, is a standing memory of the past that people avoid, preferring to forget its haunting existence. Over the years, it has stood as a silent character in numerous ghost stories narrated in hushed voices around the town. To say it was just another apartment building would be to deny its long-standing status as the town's most edifice. Sarah, a vibrant girl with an adventurous spirit, isn't one to back down from a challenge. She doesn't believe in the supernatural and dismisses these ghostly tales as mere urban legends. Fueled by her adventurous spirit and her inherent skepticism towards the supernatural, she decides to take up the delivery order. As she arrived at the dilapidated building, she could sense a shift in the atmosphere. The air, thick with an unspoken sense of unease and mystery, sent a chill down her spine. The rustling leaves and the creaking branches added to the eerie quietude that enveloped the place. She felt the hairs on the back of her neck stand up, a primal response to an unseen fear. Sarah bravely pushed open the heavy wooden doors of the building. The dimly lit hallways flickered under the unstable lighting, creating an illusion of uncanny shadows playing on the walls. Suddenly, a gust of wind howled through the place, slamming the doors shut behind her, making her jump. The echo reverberated through the empty hallways, a startling reminder of her solitude. It was then that Sarah began hearing the whispers. The words were too faint, almost like a sigh carried by the wind, but loud enough to make her heart race. She was alone, but in the unnerving silence of the building, she could not shake off the spooky feeling of being watched. Steeling herself and driven by her determination, Sarah continued to deliver the pizza, telling herself it was just her mind playing tricks on her. However, as she walked out of the building, she couldn't ignore the goosebumps prickling her skin. The nagging feeling of unease clung to her. She came for a pizza delivery, but left with a story that sent shivers down her spine, a ghostly tale to narrate to whoever dared to listen. The question remains, would you have had the courage to deliver that pizza? Ever delivered a pizza to a place that delivers you a curse? Meet Mike, an experienced delivery man who spent years on the job. He's seen neighborhoods that were affluent and some that were down at heel. He's had pizzas snatched away without payment, received generous tips from unexpected sources, and discovered hidden gems in quaint, out-of-the-way locales. He's encountered all sorts of customers, from the welcoming to the hostile, and from the appreciative to the indifferent. But nothing in his extensive experience could have prepared him for what was about to unfold on a chilly, foreboding night. One evening, as the sun was setting and the streets were beginning to darken, the phone at his pizzeria rang out. The voice on the other end was a strange, raspy whisper asking for a pizza delivery to a long-abandoned pizzeria. Mike was puzzled. Why would anyone be at that abandoned place, and why would they order pizza? But he didn't question it. He was a delivery guy. His job was to deliver, not to ask questions. The journey was uneventful, marked by the soft hum of his delivery van's engine and the faint rustle of the pizza box on the passenger seat. But as he approached the forgotten pizzeria, he could feel a chill creeping into the air, slowly snaking its way up his spine. The building stood there, derelict and ominous, its windows staring blankly at him like the empty eyes of a skull. Steeling himself, he stepped out of his van and walked towards the entrance. His footsteps echoed in the desolate silence, a reminder that he was alone in a place that had been devoid of life. For, as he pushed open the creaky door, shadows danced in the corners of his vision, flickering like ghosts of long-deceased employees forever trapped in their routine. The air was heavy, the silence oppressive. It was as though the air itself was hiding secrets, stories of past horror. Ever the professional, Mike pressed on, his mind focused on one delivering the pizza. He could feel a weight on his shoulders, a growing uneasiness that refused to be ignored. But he shrugged it off, attributing it to the eerie surroundings and the unsettling circumstances. He left the pizza and turned to leave, but not before he felt a chill, a sudden coldness that was more than just the night air. That was when he knew he'd been marked. From that day forward, his life was never the same. His was haunted by nightmares, his days filled with a nagging feeling of being watched. Bad luck seemed to trail him like a shadow, making his previously ordinary life a living nightmare. He'd gone to deliver a pizza, but he'd gotten in return was a curse that followed him, changed him, turned his life upside down. So the question remains, would you dare to deliver in such a place? After the chilling encounter at the Cursed Pizzeria, Mike's life was thrown into turmoil. His dreams were haunted by whispers and shadows, and his days were marred by a string of unfortunate events. It was as if he was living under a dark cloud, a cloud that refused to lift, casting a long, ominous shadow over his existence. Imagine waking up in the middle of the night, drenched in sweat, heart pounding, from nightmares that feel all too real. Imagine going about your day with the constant feeling of being watched, of being followed. Imagine every step you take, every decision you make, being marred by inexplicable bad luck. That was the reality of Mike's life after the delivery to the abandoned pizzeria. His usual cheerful demeanor was replaced by a pall of gloom. His once vibrant eyes now held a haunted look. His friends and family noticed the change, but Mike couldn't bring himself to explain, to tell them about the curse he'd unknowingly brought upon himself. They wouldn't understand, they wouldn't believe him. In the end, Mike decided to face his curse alone. He began researching about the abandoned pizzeria, digging into its past, trying to find a way to break the curse. He discovered tales of a tragic fire that had claimed the lives of the pizzeria's owners and employees, of rumors about a treasure hidden in the building that had supposedly attracted the curse. He found stories of other deliverymen who had experienced similar fates after delivering to the pizzeria. As Mike delves deeper into the mystery, he realizes that his only hope of breaking the curse lies in returning to the abandoned pizzeria, to face his fears, to confront the unseen terror. The question remains, will he find the courage to do so? And will he succeed in breaking the curse? Or will he become another victim of the cursed pizzeria? As we wrap up our terrifying tales, remember, every pizza delivery isn't just a job, it's an adventure, sometimes a chilling one. We began with the slice of terror and took you through a series of spine-chilling stories, each more terrifying than the last. From the late-night call that sent shivers down your spine to the desolate house that held unspeakable horrors. We took you through the unseen terror that lurks in the shadows and the haunted apartment that knows no rest. And finally, we shared the harrowing tale of Mike and his encounter with the unforgiving curse of the cursed pizzeria. As we ponder over these tales, we can't help but wonder about the fate of Mike. Will he find the courage to face his fears and break the curse? Or will he become another tragic tale associated with the cursed pizzeria? As we wait to find out, we leave you with a chilling thought. Every pizza delivery isn't just a job, it's an adventure, sometimes a chilling one. Until next time, stay safe. And remember, the next time you order a pizza, you never know what might come with it. Every knock on your door could be the beginning of a terrifying tale. Keep your wits about you and your pizza cutter handy. Sweet dreams. Before we wrap up, we have a small request. If you enjoyed our terrifying tales, we'd appreciate it if you could subscribe to our channel for more. Each subscription is a vote for more spine-chilling stories, more late-night calls, more desolate houses, and more unforgiving curses. If you liked our video, please give it a thumbs up. Your likes are the fuel that keeps our fires of fright burning bright. And remember, every tale of terror is unique, just like every pizza delivery. We'd love to hear about your own chilling encounters and eerie experiences. So don't shy away from sharing your thoughts and stories in the comments section below. Maybe your tale will become a part of our next series of terrifying tales. Your support helps us bring more terrifying tales to you. Until next time, stay safe, keep your pizza cutter handy, and remember, every knock on your door could be the beginning of a terrifying tale. Sweet dreams!